Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. This is episode 10 of the 120 Days to Jam Chemistry with Flash Isaac. This is the last dance of chemical combination. Everything ends here. The first question here says, in the equation above, what are the values of S, Y, and Z? This is solid. This is hydrochloric acid, aqueous. If it were gaseous state, it would have been hydrogen chloride. This is manganese chloride, water in liquid state, and chlorine gas. Looking at this, to balance this equation, looking for the value of S, Y, and Z simply means balance the equation. The best way to answer questions like this is follow the options and see the one that will give you a balanced equation. Respectively means S first, then Y, then Z. Option A says S is 4. S is 4. If S is 4, it simply means in the reactant side, we have 4 hydrogen and 4 chlorine. Let's see the product side. Here, and it says Y is 2 and Z is 1. So if Y is 2 and Z is 1, how many hydrogen would we have in the product side? In the product side, we have 4 hydrogen. And how many chlorine? 2 here, 1 here. That is 4 chlorine. It is actually correct to look at it. If here is 4, here is 2, and here is 1. Manganese in the reactant side is 1, in the product side, 1. Oxygen in the reactant side is 2. In the product side, oxygen will also be 2. Oxygen is 2. Hydrogen in the reactant side, 4. In the product side, hydrogen is 2 times 2, 4. Chlorine in the reactant side will be 4. In the product side, chlorine will be, there's already 2 here. If you put 1 here, 1 times 2 is 2. That is 4. It is balanced too. So, option A is the correct option. What mass of water is produced when 8 grams of hydrogen gas or hydrogen react with excess oxygen? What mass of water is produced? Hydrogen reacts with oxygen to form H2O, which means we need 2 moles of hydrogen to react with 1 mole of oxygen to form how many moles of water? 2H2O to form 2 moles of water. That is a balanced equation. 1 mole of a substance is also equals the mass of that substance. If you are given hydrogen, what should be is that 2 moles of hydrogen gas react with 1 mole of oxygen to give you 2 moles of water. In terms of mass, we will need 4 grams of hydrogen to react with 32 grams of oxygen to form 36 grams of water, which is the masses or the molar mass, grams per mole actually. 4 grams of hydrogen produces 36 grams of water. And remember, we are told that oxygen is in excess. The excess reagent does not determine the product form. What determines the product form is hydrogen, since hydrogen is a limited reagent. And what should be is that we need 4 grams of hydrogen to produce 36 grams of water. Now we are given just 8 grams of hydrogen. So what will 8 grams of hydrogen produce when it comes to water? Call it S. You therefore say that if 4 grams produce 36, 8 grams should produce S. Cross multiplying, 4 times S is equals 36 times 8. S is therefore 36 times 8 over 4. This is 36 times 2. And would that give you 72? Yes. So C is the correct option. And the next question says, what volume of oxygen is required to burn completely 45 cm cube of methane at standard temperature and pressure? Balance equations matters. Oxygen, we are burning methane. Methane is CH4. By the time we are done with all the episodes, you know all the compounds, their reactions, and the result. Your own is to follow. Get the app for personal practice. Comment, ask questions. Plus oxygen, 2O2 to give us CO2 plus 2H2O. What volume of oxygen is required to burn completely 45 cm cube of methane? So we are concerned about oxygen and this, about the reactant. What should be is that we need 1 mole of methane to react with 2 moles of oxygen to form 1 mole of CO2 and 2 moles of water. 1:2:1:2. And if 1 mole of a substance at standard temperature and pressure will contain 22.4 dm³. So that is the volume of 1 mole of substance. So how do we get the volume of methane that is required? See, this is 1:2. If 1 is 45 cm³, 2 should be 90. So here is 90 cm³. It therefore implies that we need 90 cm³ of oxygen to burn 45 cm³ of methane. 90 cm³ of oxygen to burn completely 45 cm³ of methane. Is there more? I was even taking it as a serious question. That's the answer. Just the way we've been doing stoichiometry since. This is the equation of reaction. So this time around, they are not telling you to balance the equation. They've given you the equation. What should be is that we need 2 moles of sodium to react with 2 moles of hydrogen gas or of hydrogen to give us 2 moles of sodium hydroxide and 1 mole of water. So according to reaction, we have 2:2:2. That is how it should be. Then since we are given the mass of sodium hydroxide. Calculate the mass of sodium hydroxide produced by 2.3 grams of sodium. So when you still see mass produced, what you do is you compare the mass that should be to the mass that you are given. And our concern for this question is the mass of sodium hydroxide produced by sodium. So we are concerned with sodium and sodium hydroxide. What should be is that we need the mass of sodium. Molar mass of sodium is 23 times 2, that is 46. We need 46 grams of sodium to react with hydrogen, although 4 grams of hydrogen, but we are not more concerned about hydrogen, to give us the mass of sodium hydroxide is 23 plus oxygen is 16 plus hydrogen is 1. This is 40. We have 2 moles. So 2 moles of sodium hydroxide is 40 times 2, 80 grams. 80 grams. What should be is that we need 46 grams of sodium to produce 80 grams of sodium hydroxide. And now we are given 2.3 grams of sodium. So 2.3 grams of sodium will produce what? S. Cross multiplying, 46 times S is equals 2.3. Is equals 80 times 2.3. So S will simply be 4 grams. The mass of sodium hydroxide produced by 2.3 grams of sodium is simply 4 grams, as you can see there. How many atoms are present in 6 grams of magnesium? 6 grams of magnesium. You see, this is the normal comparison. Magnesium. The molar mass of magnesium is 24. Sodium, magnesium. So, how many atoms are present in 6 grams of magnesium? You compare what should be to what is. Since 1 mole of magnesium is 24 grams, so 1 mole of any substance will contain the Avogadro's number, which is 6.02 × 10⁻², number of molecules. So 1 mole of magnesium contains 6.02 × 10⁻². Molecules. Now, mole as mass. 1 mole of magnesium is 24 grams. So 24 grams of magnesium contains 6.02 × 10⁻². Molecules. Therefore, what will 6 grams of magnesium contain? If 24 grams contains this, 6 grams will contain S. So S is equals 6.02 × 10⁻²⁶ all over 24. And that should give you 1.51 × 10⁻²³, if I am correct. If I am wrong, do the correct thing. What volume of 0.25 mole per dm cube hydrochloric acid would be required to dissolve 0.48 grams of magnesium completely? We need hydrochloric acid, 2HCl aqueous, to react with magnesium to form MgCl2 plus H2. This is the balanced equation. We are told that what volume of 0.25 mole per dm cube volume of hydrochloric acid will be required to dissolve this magnesium to produce, to dissolve this guy completely. Look at something. That 0.25 mole per dm cube you are given is concentration. And anytime you are given value, if maybe 0.25 big M, it also represents concentration, big M. In that case, there is chance that you will use this formula. Big chance when you have concentration. Either this formula or this formula. But looking at the options, we are given the answers in CM cube. So if you are solving in CM cube, we'll use this formula. Number of moles is equals concentration times volume over 1000. If you are solving in CM cube. If you are solving in dm cube, no need to divide by 1000. From here, the concentration C is equals 0.25 mole per dm cube. And we are given the mass of magnesium. Magnesium is 0.48 grams. What else? That is it. We need what? The volume of HCl. What we need is the volume of HCl. From the balanced equation, we need 2 moles of HCl to react with 1 mole of magnesium to form 1 mole of magnesium chloride and this. So, this is at what should be. What should? The question should tell us what is. What is that we have, they also give us molar mass of magnesium to be 24. We have mass of magnesium and molar mass of magnesium. Since we have mass of magnesium and molar mass of magnesium, we can simply find the number of moles of magnesium, because number of moles is mass over molar mass. So this is simply 0.48 over 24. That is 0.02. So the number of moles of magnesium is 0.02. This number of moles is what we are given. Comparing to what should be, if we need 2 moles of HCl to react with 1 mole of magnesium, it means 0.02 moles of magnesium will react with 0.04 moles of HCl, Because if 1 is 0.02, 2 will be 0.02 times 2. So this is what we need. Back to here. Number of moles is CV over 1000. But we are looking for V. Making V subject formula, volume is number of moles times 1000 over concentration. Now the number of moles here, is this for magnesium or for HCl? We are using the number of moles of HCl because it is the volume of HCl we are looking for. So we use the number of moles of HCl, 0.04 times 1000 over concentration, 0.25. Ladies and gentlemen, that is all you need. And that should give you what? What volume will that give you? 160 cm cube. That is the answer to that question. A solution of sodium hydroxide containing 0.6 grams in 250 cm cube of solution has a concentration of that. Concentration is number of mole is concentration times volume. Number of mole is concentration times volume over 1000. Now the volume is in cm cube. It simply means we are making use of this formula. Concentration is number of moles times 1000 over volume. So what is the number of moles? Number of moles is mass times molar mass. And the mass of sodium hydroxide, NaOH given, is 0.6 grams. The molar mass of sodium hydroxide is 40. So the concentration is mass over molar mass, that is 0.6 over 40 times 1000 over volume, 250. So that should give you 0.06. So that is the concentration. So all these things, when you read the question, they get so confusing, so crazy, you feel you can't do anything. But they are very, very simple. So this is why I've dedicated my strength to make sure I do all the questions in stoichiometry and chemical combination. I think I deserve some accolade. Oxygen in air can be removed using alkaline pyrogallop is what we use to remove oxygen. Option C is the correct option. And this one says, what volume of hydrogen will be produced if 100 cm cube of ammonia is completely decomposed at constant temperature and pressure? The ratio is 2:1:3. So if ammonia is ratio 2 and we are given 100 cm cube, nitrogen is ratio 1. Ratio 1 should be what? 50 cm cube. And if ratio 1 is 50 cm cube, hydrogen is ratio 3. Ratio 3 should be what? 50 times 3. That is 150 cm cube. So it should be 2:1:3 is 100 cm cube, ratio 50 cm cube, ratio 150 cm cube. So option B is the correct option. You see, you don't need to solve in most of these questions. And look at this one. It's like the first question we solved in stoichiometry. But this is something I want to point out. 20 cm cube of hydrogen gas are sparked with 20 cm cube of oxygen gas in an ND mole ether, whatever, at 373 Kelvin, 100 degrees Celsius, and 1 atmosphere. The resulting mixture is cooled to 298 Kelvin and passed over calcium chloride. The volume of the residual gas is dash. Now look at something. I told you volume of residual gas is the volume of the product plus the volume of the gas that is in excess. That is the volume of the residual gas. Now hydrogen is packed with oxygen. When hydrogen is packed with oxygen, what do you form? You form water. So the volume of the residual gas will be the volume of the water formed, the volume of the gas that is in excess remaining, and if it is air, any other part of the air. But here, it's packed with 20 cm cube of oxygen gas, hydrogen, but it says that the resulting mixture is cooled. What is formed is water, gas. Now that the gas has been cooled, it will go back to liquid. So it has condensed. In that case,
What the product is no longer a gas, it has changed to liquid. The volume of the resulting gas will simply be the excess we have in oxygen, that is 10 cm3. So the excess oxygen remaining is the only resulting gas, because water produced has been cooled to liquid, no longer a gas. Take note of all that. Ask questions if you have, and go through these videos again. See you in the next episode, which promises a new topic.